this MOOC, we're going to travel across Wisconsin. We're going to show you examples of beautiful forests like the one that I'm sitting in now. We're going to show you prairies and wetlands, and many of those habitats have been preserved by the activity of hunters and by the money that hunters raise. And that's one level of sustainability.
I grew up here on this landscape, and it's a place where Elder Leopold had practiced game management and conservation techniques some 40 years earlier.
Elder Leopold's legacy of the land ethic matters in the way we manage and conserve our resources.
We're also going to talk a little bit about the ethics, the population biology, and the way that those two things interact to determine whether or not conservation can really be achieved at a deeper level.
Using the perfect case study of Montana, where elk hunting is an enormous, big trophy business, I'm going to show you the basic conundrum that presents itself when you try to manage wild things.
We have to get really creative about how we spread conservation around, looking for areas on farms and in neighborhoods and even cities where we can enhance and restore wildlife habitat.
And I hope we learn a little bit about what it means to be perceptive. Perception is a term that comes from Aldo Leopold's writing, and it has to do with an expanded view of our role in the ecosystem and how we participate in ecosystems as hunters.
Because all wildlife, except when they're in zoos, tend to move around, which means some of the time they're on public land and some of the time they're on private land. Working with private landowners means private property rights and the management of resources for private good. The management of public land falls to state and local authorities who have many competing demands on who gets access, what the resources are for, and how they should be managed. Putting private landowners and public landowners together to create an outcome that everybody likes turns out to be harder than you'd think. Who owns the right to hunt an elk?
As Leopold's thinking evolved, he too believed that conservation on private lands was really key, and he experimented with providing conservation and hunting opportunities by working with rural landowners. Today, we have a number of elaborate tools and conservation strategies for looking at things like habitat connectivity and evaluating trade-offs in land management. Here, we'll show you how Leopold's outreach with rural landowners can inform our conservation options today.
And whether or not you're an active hunter and may have a background in hunting, or whether you're simply curious, I hope that we open your eyes a little bit to the broader conservation issues.
If you're a landowner, if you're a land manager, or you're just somebody who cares about wildlife, the policies that we assemble to manage those animals will determine the future of the wild.